Okay, we're at 10 seconds in, so we're going to get started. So we are continuing with the unicorn plaque. However, today we're going to work on the other side of it. Don't remember if I've shown you guys, but the other side I've actually painted a Kelpie. And so we will be doing that today. Now, I'm still getting things ready a little bit, but what I'm doing, normally you guys don't see me work with a painter's palette, but today we're going to be mixing some colors. Okay, that one just doesn't want to come out. Now it's flowing, it's just very slow. Oh well. We'll deal with that if we get to it. Okay. I'm going to be trying to mix up some rather unpleasant looking colors, to be honest. Because this is going to be the counterpoint to the unicorn. Some of these just do not want to come out. Okay then. Well, I'll deal with them when I want to. So, also made the unwise decision to use the back of one of my paintbrushes to get some stuck paint that was still tacky and wet, just stuck. So now I'm having to clean the back of the brush. So yes, that was an unwise choice. C'est la vie, not my first. Okay. So we will cap this until I'm going to try one more time. Nope. Okay. Well, that's fine. Well, I can work around that. Okay. So let's go ahead and put this in place. So yes, this is the other side of the unicorn. I actually have a different set of brushes that I'm going to use for part of this. Mostly because they're not particularly expensive brushes, and I don't care if they get messed up some. Okay, so. Sorry if I go quiet like this, but my roommate is still in the hospital and I'm having to talk to him sometimes. Okay, so currently limited palette, and there's a reason for that, because we are going to we're going to get started with mixing some of these. So, I'm wanting kind of a sickly brown, green-gray, which would have been a lot more fun and a lot easier if it had let me, you know, use all the colors I wanted. But we'll cross that bridge when we do. And I'm not too worried about the colors not mixing well, because the whole point is this is going to be kind of a mottled, blotchy, unpleasant color. I want it a little bit lighter, so we're going to get just a bit more of this orange and mix that in. Okay. Now, I'm going to be avoiding painting over the pencil lines for right now. So I'm just kind of going around them, because I will be going over those pencil lines later with a different color. But for the moment, we're focusing on just giving our Kelpie this sickly, unhealthy pallor. And again, if it's kind of blotchy, that's okay, because it is not supposed to be a healthy looking color. This is not our pretty, pretty, perfect princess unicorn, you know. This is, well, frankly, it's a Kelpie. It's a man-eater. It, convinces people to ride on its back and then drags them into water, drowns them, and eats them. It's okay if I cover up the pencil lines a little bit, as long as I leave enough space I can really tell where I need to put those lines. The reason I haven't gone over the lines yet, and I'm leaving them, is because I haven't yet decided if I want to do them in black or in white. Because I want this to be a contrast to the unicorn, but I also don't want it to lose out on some of the focus by having it be like a reversed image. So, for the moment, we're just kind of going along these edges, making certain we have good coverage where we do cover things. I'll probably end up doing it in black, because I did like how the black on the white gave it a very almost comic book feel on the unicorn side. But we'll probably what I'll do is I'll do a small test at some point in one of the less noticeable areas. See how I like it, see if it looks good to me. And if it doesn't, then I'll try a different color. And if it seems weird that I'm kind of moving from spot to spot, that's because I know I'm never going to be able to get this exact colored to match again, because I'm mixing it as I go. So what I'm doing is I'm spreading out the color so that when I inevitably make the next bit of it, and it looks slightly different, it's still slightly different all over, instead of, well, this is one color and this is another, and goal is to play into that. Blotchy, unhealthy, splotched look. Okay, so now I'm almost out of my initial mixed up color. Get some of this area up between. I know that I am not a good enough artist to match a color perfectly every time, so. Now, we'll go ahead and mix up the next color. This time we're going to work, instead of this blue-green, we're going to work with this brighter green. And some of the orange. That already looks pretty gross. Perfect, that's what I want. So we're gonna giving us an almost with how it is blending imperfectly together. I am liking how this is turning out already, which is surprising. Normally, first time I'm working on it, I'm like, is this really going to work? And then it turns out, because as I saw recently from somebody, the trick to turning something bad into something good is to not stop. You just keep going until you've made something that you like. Okay, time to mix up another one. This time we're going to start with the brown, the lighter brown, and the orange. I'm going to add a bit of the darker brown to it. And then some of the lighter green. There we go. Now I'm getting a brown with a green undertone, which is my goal. Like I said, goal here is not a pretty, pretty, perfect creature. It is a sickly and unpleasant something that has seen the world of man and found it very lacking in worth. Kind of makes sense that I'm doing it as a almost camouflaged shading. I mean, whole point of the Kelpie is to lie in wait and then try to convince somebody to get on its back. So effectively, they're an ambush predator. And therefore, it makes sense that they'd be camouflaged to hide within an aquatic area. Sorry, we are eagerly awaiting the results of a test that will hopefully tell us what the heck is causing these seizures. That my roommate is having. Big hope is if we can find out what's causing them, then we can, you know, put a stop to them so they don't happen anymore. It's going to require a finer tip brush than what I'm using. I'm almost out of this color, too. Thoroughly unfortunate looking creature. Okay, so now we'll get more of that bluish green and a good bit of orange, some of the dark brown again. And what I'm doing here is just kind of filling in any little spots of white with this darker color, trying to get right along those lines. You would think with how humid today is, the wood wouldn't just be soaking up every drop of paint I put on it, but apparently so. Which is okay. I mean, it works out in the better for us eventually. Once again, I'm skirting right along the edge of the paint of the drawn lines. Spots like this, they don't need a lot, but I want to make sure I cover them still. I still haven't decided if I want to pick these out in black or white on these lines.
Still not back?
Honey, I'm streaming.
Sorry.
But no, he's not back yet. I actually chose the rougher side of the wood on this plaque for the Kelpie. To try and encourage that unpleasant, unhealthy, possibly sick look to it. So, I think I'm doing a dang good job of that. I don't know, I think it's coming along pretty well. Go ahead and get the base of the neck here. Just try to fill in these gaps. preferably without painting over the lines on it. Just caught where I made an error earlier. Oh well. That's the fun of things like this, is if I mess up, it's not the end of the world. Because, I mean, I'm using paints I already had. And the plaque cost me about $25 at Dollar Tree. If I do this again in the future, I think I'm going to want to make it a point to paint the hair first, or the mane, so that I don't make the mistake of accidentally painting the wrong spot like I did earlier. But again, it's a super simple fix to take care of that. I do like how that white contrast, where it's not painted, I might use the white to pick out over it. We'll see. I should probably be using a thinner brush for this bit, but already started. Too fussed with changing it. Okay. Just a few more spots of touch-up and we'll be done. At least with this part. Might as well move on to the mane now. Let's clean my brush. Mental note, next time use a bigger paint jar that can fit my brush cleaner in it. Okay. That is not properly clean, but it'll have to do. You can tell it's not properly clean by those little spots where I just wiped the brush against my thing. I'll try and get it a little cleaner. Not perfect, but it'll do. Okay, so now I'm going to try for a lighter color for the mane at this point. And this isn't going to be for all of the mane. This is just for some of it. Oh, that's an appropriately disgusting looking color. Got way more of it on my brush than what I want. Okay, let's start with didn't look that bad. I mean, it looks bad, but it's supposed to. It looks bad in the way it's supposed to. Let's phrase it that way. So, honestly, I'm liking how this is turning out, and I'm wondering if I'm even going to need to delineate the mane itself. I might just need to do the white along the jawline and around the eye. We'll see. The goal with the mane when I drew it was to make it look like kelp or seaweed. And I think I did a pretty bang up job on that. Actually, I'm not minding too much where the lines show through, because that just kind of adds to what I was going for on this. Sorry, I keep going quiet, by the way. It's me, focusing, but I'm liking it. Okay, I'm gonna change up the mane just a bit by mixing some more orange into it. So we're still going to be using basically the same color, just slightly different. Because I want to be able to differentiate between the strands of seaweed. But if I'm not going to go over the lines between them, then... Oh, that was a mistake. Not in the painting. I sat in a way that was more comfortable, and then I realized that to continue to paint using that way of seating, I would have to... Alright. That doesn't look quite as different as I want, so we're adding more of the orange. Fine, we'll add a lot more of the orange. Trying not to block y'all's view. Sure, how can it put on sharp? Okay. Wanted to see how that would look without the bright light on it. And I do like what I'm seeing. So. Let's come over here. I was going to be using a lot of yellow in this, but the yellow paint did not want to cooperate and come out of the paint canister. So, yellow is just not, gonna get to come out until it reaches the point where I just need it and not mixed with anything else. Which at this point is going to be fairly soon. Let's see. Okay, one more. And for this one, we're going to darken that last color up some by adding some of the dark brown. I don't want it to be a huge shift, but... definitely going to be a different color, so. And I'll let you guys see things again without the bright light here in a few. For the moment, the light is just there to make certain I don't miss any spots. Just change the okay, that shows you guys what I've done a bit better. Alright. Sorry, shirt came up over my belly. You know what? I'm thinking now, maybe I don't want to use orange is not a bad addition. This one and our black. Oh, I remember the black is very gooey. Not quite what I was looking for, but not bad. Now, we're going to swap to gray. Let's use something. It's got a fine point, but it's not quite what I'm looking for. What about you? You're basically the same brush I was originally using, just... Okay, that will definitely have to be lined, but it's not a bad choice stylistically. Can be a bit more generous with the paint over here since I've got a wider area to work in. I have no idea what I'm doing with the horn. I'll probably finish that up on next week's crafting stream because that'll give me a week to think about how I want it to look. So the parts where I've got the gray, they are going to have to be lined. Just because it does not stand out as much as I wanted it to. But that's okay. Big decision remains, do I want to line it with gray or do I want to line it with black or white with or with black? Okay. All right. So, we made a lot of progress. Going to use one more brush to fill in a small gap. I like it. I really do. And I know most artists don't say that very often, so, you know. Not that I consider myself an artist, but still. Okay. I think that looks really good. I've just got a little bit of lining and touch-up work, and then I've got to figure out what to do with the horn. But I think we can call it good for today. Thank you guys so much for joining me on stream. I hope that you guys all have a beautiful rest of your week and that you enjoyed getting to watch me work on this particular project. Let's see, there we go. So, got the kelpie side, and we got the unicorn side. And I'm really liking how it's turning out. So I do want to thank everyone for coming out to the stream again. I hope that you all have a beautiful rest of your week. Take care of yourself. Take care of each other. And I'll see you next time.